Welcome to this video tutorial about the medium voltage network. In this video, we'll explain how to draw a single line diagram and calculate the rated current and short circuit current to size your equipment. To create a medium voltage single line diagram, click on Create a New SLD from your project dashboard in the Connect Partner Hub. When setting the diagram parameters, choose the medium voltage power supply to work also with a medium voltage environment and products. To help you at this step, please refer to video number 1. Block diagram is the main starting page where all switch gears are showed. Medium voltage elements are identified in orange. With DOCweb, it is possible to mix low voltage and medium voltage elements on the same diagram. By default, one medium and one low voltage switchgear are present in addition to the network, but other switchgears can be added as per project requirements. Compared to the previous version of DOC 3, the Block Diagram tab will give you a global view of the low voltage and medium voltage switchboard included in the project. You can set their properties with a single click. The Block Diagram tab also gives an overview of the switchgear and its connections. Under the New Page tab, you can compose your single line diagram with the elements offered by DOCweb. Note that the common drop-down menu contains elements valid for both low voltage and medium voltage network, like cables, loads, or transformers. Specific panels for medium voltage are sorted under the medium voltage drop-down selection and split by switchgear type. To draw a single line diagram, simply drag and drop the desired panel onto the sheet. For example, start by choosing a primary switchgear with an incoming and outgoing panel. Drag and drop the panels, placing panels close to each other to create the desired medium voltage switchgear. Each panel is identified by an abbreviation and an icon, but more detailed information can be accessed via the information button. To connect your panels to medium voltage network, drag and drop the connection from the bottom of the incoming panel to the power supply. To have a valid design, at least two panels must be in your switchgear. After creating your unigear primary distribution switchgear, it is possible to mix it with another switchgear, for example, with the unisex secondary distribution switchgear on the same sheet. To do so, go back to the Block Diagram tab and add a new medium voltage switchboard, automatically named Switchboard 2. On the Design tab, start by adding secondary distribution panels to your diagram from the unisex section. Then, make sure that every panel is related to your new switchboard 2. To set the correct switchboard, click on the panel, and on the right column, check under Circuit that switchboard 2 is selected. After creating an additional switchgear, connect the two switchgears by dragging and dropping a cable at their bottom as done to connect the incoming to the network. A low-voltage switchgear can also be added to the diagram, as DOCweb is able to calculate both low-voltage and medium-voltage schemes. Simply add a transformer under your medium-voltage switchgear to connect a low-voltage panel. Alternatively, add a medium-voltage load to complete the circuit. Once your diagram is complete, DOCweb calculates it. To perform this step, simply click on the calculator icon up on top. DOCweb can also be set on auto calculation mode. When this mode is activated, DOCweb will calculate the network at every single change. The console feedback notifies you if an error has occurred. With the warning notification, the system displays a description to help you correct the error. Clicking on the notification opens the corresponding object properties section. If everything is well built, the feedback appears in green. DOCweb recognizes the network from the single line diagram and automatically adds the connection between blocks under the Block Diagram tab. The right column displays information about the selected switchgear. Under Switchgear Settings, the product name is given automatically and is unchangeable as it is linked to the designed single line diagram. However, the Switchgear Settings section will allow you to change the braking technology. Under Service, the values in gray have been calculated by DOCweb and are the real calculated data of the network. With the Rated section, you can choose different values for your switchgear. By default, DOCweb selects the values closest to your network calculation, but it is possible to choose higher values to satisfy project requirements. Back on the Switchgear Edition page, click on a panel composing a switchgear to access its settings via the menu on the right. From here, you can set different circuit breaker ratings, protection relays, current and voltage transformers, or sensors. In the drop-down list, the elements in black are compatible and will not impact the selection of other products. Elements in gray are also available but will automatically affect the selection of other products. Each main panel component is identified by its product name, but more detailed information can be accessed via the Information button. At this step, the curves have also been calculated, but depending on your project need, a different setting can be set with a cursor below the curve. The curves can also be exported and displayed under the dedicated software CurvesWeb, accessible via the Partner Hub. To find out more about CurvesWeb, please refer to video number 4. To access the ABB Connect Partner Hub, please visit our website at partnerhub.connect.abb.com or contact your local ABB representative.